Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube, and this morning we're going to talk a little golf. We're going to talk a little travel. You've got only me and, of course, my sidekick, Mike McGann. Thanks for joining us.
Who? Oh, yeah, that guy. Good morning, Dan. How are you?
I am doing great. How about yourself?
I am moving right along, my friend. Happy Sunday morning to you.
Yeah, it's nice. I guess the season finally changed around here. We got some cooler weather.
It has been amazing. I tend to take walks late at night. Like, I take walks like 11:30 at night.
Uh-huh.
And instead of like wearing normal, some kind of sweater, I wear my blazers. And I wonder what people must think if they look outside and see a dude dressed like that at midnight.
Yeah. Well, it gives some of the women a chance to wear their furs.
Excellent point. Very good.
Gotta take them out of storage.
That's a big plus, actually.
The fake furs, of course. We don't like to kill any animals on this show. Fake furs. Be politically correct.
I do like a cheeseburger.
Yeah, there you go. I do too. So
all right.
But I admit to that. Okay. But in any event, the golf world, it's been a little bit busy, but it is starting to calm down. Of course, last week we had that, what they call the match with Charles Barkley and Phil Mickelson against Stephen Curry and Peyton Manning. And it was pretty much what it was built to be. It was fun. It was a chat fest, a lot of talk. The outcome, though, was from the beginning was not necessarily what the bookies and odds makers and people expected. I was fooled. I thought that Curry and Manning, both being very good golfers, would have an easy time of it with Mickelson, who obviously is a great golfer, but Barkley, who's been known to be one of the worst in the history of the game.
Yes, that's very true. Yes.
Barkley had said that he was practicing 5 hours a day for like 5-6 months, and people would be surprised, and nobody believed him. And he was telling the truth. His swing was dramatically improved.
Really? He was that much better, huh?
That much better. He had this horrible hitch in his swing. He would like start and then stop in the middle and then start again. And it was painful to watch, and it was all gone. He hit like the first three fairways in a row and, you know, had an occasional miss here and there. But he was being coached by Mickelson, which was really interesting because constant coaching and the information that he was giving Barkley was helpful for any golfer to learn. So that was cool. And their strategy, whereby they didn't need Barkley to make wonderful shots, they just needed to keep it in play kind of so that Mickelson could make great shots.
They needed consistency, basically.
Right, and it worked. And it worked. They beat up on him bad, and it was entertaining, and the golf course was beautiful. And
if anyone, really, if Barkley's golf game can improve to that level,
it's a testament for lessons.
It really is. I mean, lessons, practice, you can get better at things. It's inspirational.
You can, but if you practice without the lessons, you just get better at being bad.
Well, that's a good point. You need somebody who's going
to
show you.
Right, to show the right technique and then practice that. And that, it's a miracle.
But it works.
So before you go out and spend thousands of dollars on new golf clubs, get a swing.
Yeah.
Because it's much more important.
Always go back to fundamentals.
There you go. So we learned that. So that was pretty cool.
That's a cool story.
Finishing up later today is the Mayakoba Golf Classic on the PGA Tour in Mexico. Great field. And the last real event for this calendar year, at least, on the PGA Tour. They'll start up with real events in January. But there will be some fun events, and we'll be talking about those as well. For one, I know the father-son tournament, a lot of players are looking forward to. That's going to be in a week or two up in the Orlando area, so maybe we'll talk more about that next week.
Okay.
The women are playing as well in Texas at the Volunteers of America Classic, so that'll be finishing up later today as well. Other golf news, the Phoenix Open, which takes place in February, famous for their 16th hole, their stadium hole where they've got about 20,000 screaming drunk fans. They are moving forward with plans for fans and a smaller stadium. So, okay. You know, kind of like football, you know, they're going to be open and have fans, but to a lesser percent, perhaps, to try and keep everybody safe. So, you know, we'll see how that works. I mean, that is one event that the fans make a huge difference. It's literally a party. But I think we've all come to learn that watching sports on TV, even when there are no fans, is better than having nothing at all.
Oh, I agree completely. I mean,
the players, yeah, they miss having the fans to cheer them on, but they're professionals. They're playing for a paycheck. They're very competitive. The golf courses are beautiful. The game is great, and watching it without the fans, definitely better than nothing at all.
And there's also been, you know, a lot of technological improvements as far as ways, yes, to kind of create that ambiance.
Yes.
And
we get to hear more about what the pros are saying. I mean, I noticed it on the football. I was watching football this week.
Right there.
You can hear everything, and it's kind of fascinating.
Industry is pivoting in a lot of ways to accommodate this, and I love that they're finding new and different technologies that then, as things do get more back to normal, there are still going to be applications for these things.
There are. Another positive for golf and for Las Vegas, and we talk a lot about Las Vegas because I typically like to visit there, and obviously it's a barometer for the tourism industry.
Sure.
While the hotels and the strip and the shows are all suffering dramatically, the golf courses are booming in Las Vegas.
I bet they are.
So just like here, just like everywhere else, I guess that there's enough people that live locally who are playing, as well as those people who are traveling.
Right.
People who travel to Las Vegas, the casinos are still open. You can't go to the shows. They're not open.
Right.
But the golf courses are open. And very few people that I know can gamble 24/7. It typically, even if you're a good gambler, the house will always win the longer you play.
Oh, sure.
So as somebody who loves to gamble, I'm smart enough to know that you need to find other things to do. And if you don't have shows to go to and there's less things to do, going out and playing golf for 4 or 5 hours in the, you know, in the desert is not a bad way to kill a little bit of time so you don't find yourself in the casino all day.
And it's a physics lesson.
It truly is. And it's and the sun is beautiful, and the temperatures this time of year are better. Although
Unreal.
It can get cold in, yeah, Las Vegas this time of year. August in Las Vegas, I don't like to play golf.
Well, I would imagine
so,
not.
Yeah, not the best. But in any event, I have got some interesting travel stories for you, including some that are very close to home.
Okay.
As well as some great deals on travel that will be coming up a little bit later in the show. You're not going to want to miss it, so stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
I've got the shanks so bad, worst round of golf I ever had.
Are you tired of searching for the job you need with the flexibility you want? Whether you're looking for a temporary or permanent position, you need to call Labor Finders. We're already in your community putting people back to work every day. Select from hundreds of daily job listings with companies who are hiring all over the country. With nearly 200 offices nationwide, Labor Finders has temporary and temporary to hire employment opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, and general labor positions, such as electricians, landscapers, flaggers, hospitality, and more. Connect with a personal job agent today to navigate your next career step by calling your local Labor Finders office or by visiting laborfinders.com.
Four. Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
You know, some people this time of year are listening to Bing sing White Christmas, but not here on this show. This is what we do, and this is how we do it.
Yeah, it's Christmas on the green.
Exactly. It's a green Christmas we're wishing for everybody, not necessarily a white Christmas, at least not here.
Yeah.
So this segment, we like to talk, sometimes we have a guest, but this time of year, everybody is traveling, maybe, which we're going to talk about in a minute or so.
Yes, we will.
But actually, some travel stories close to home. First of all, myself. I'm planning to meet frequent guest to our show here, Scott Price, Table Tennis Hall of Famer.
Yeah, interesting.
He just flew in from Colorado, and I am going to meet him in the Keys. So this is really my first foray into travel since the pandemic, so I'm keeping it relatively close to home.
Sure.
But he did fly in, and the update is from him, because he's already in the state, that out of Colorado, his flight on United was full.
Really?
Full flight. So people are still flying, and United has been filling those middle seats for quite some time now. They don't seem to worry about it. We did hear, though, that the airline said, scientifically proven, that the air is the safest on the airline possible, on the airplane. I also just got an email from a film producer, some documentary that just came out, talking about how unsafe the air actually is. I did not view it yet, so there's differences of opinions out there. And, you know.
I mean, honestly, you can pick a side and you can prove it. I mean, it's.
But let me tell you one more story that I just heard of. So my daughter and her husband were on their way to Hawaii, I think today. Their entire family was going. Her father-in-law, mother-in-law left ahead of them. Already got to Hawaii.
Okay.
And all of Hawaii, all of the islands currently require that you get a test to make sure you're negative within 3 days of your flight.
Right.
Kauai just decided to change that trend and decided to not go along with that. So if you're going to Kauai, you still need to quarantine for 14 days. So they all jumped on the plane. You know, the in-laws jumped on the plane. They get to the airport, I think in Maui.
Right.
They would not accept their test result because it went to a local lab here that was not one of the huge national or international players. They said, we don't know this lab. We don't trust these results. If you want to come into Hawaii, you have to quarantine for 14 days. So the father-in-law and mother-in-law are turning around and flying all the way back to Florida. Man. And the rest of the family, all the kids, are not getting on their flights because they were all leaving a little bit later. From what I've heard, the latest story is they are going to get credits for the airfare, I guess, for whatever reason. You know, they went to one of the local clinics in Martin County up where we live.
Yeah, yeah.
And they send it to some lab, but it wasn't, you know, like LabCorp or, you know, one of the big labs or something. They said, oh, we don't trust this.
Huh.
So, can you imagine flying all the way to Hawaii thinking that you followed every rule to the letter of the rule? And they did. And it still wasn't good enough. And they had to turn around and fly back.
I guess my takeaway from this is I might just be able to open a lab.
Well, you better make sure you're accredited.
But I'm saying I might be able to do something. Hey, not everybody's going to accept it, but you'll save a couple of bucks.
Yeah, maybe so. Yeah, this one looks good. This one, yeah, I'm not sure about that one.
I'll put my address on Facebook if you want to, you know, reasonable rates.
Well,
here.
You know what? There's not too many businesses you don't have a hand in lately. It seems your empire has been expanding greatly, I see. So you never know.
That is true, Dan. We'll talk about that some other
Michael's
time.
Testing.
Yeah, that's my next frontier.
So another place that we've been talking about traveling that has been open to the U.S., and a lot of people are going, there are some great deals, is Mexico. But this past week, the CDC said, do not travel to Mexico. So yet again, if you thought it was okay and you thought it was safe and you purchased your package, I mean, they're not banning people. They're just telling people you might want to think twice that the COVID is drastically expanding its presence in Mexico right now. So you might want to be careful on that. Also, if you are flying with a service animal, maybe because you're just so crazy from all these rules, regulations, or panic that you might get turned around from wherever you're going, the government, U.S. government, Department of Transportation issued a final ruling this past week that says that you can't bring your emotional support peacock with you on the plane, or gecko, or snake, or even cat, raccoon, no, pony. I don't think so. Not for mental problems, at least. You know, they're trying to keep it just to dogs now.
That sounds pretty speciesist.
At least for emotional. There you go. It might be for emotional support.
I get you.
Again, I mean, if there may be some cases where you can still bring your miniature pony. I don't know. It might be for other kind of ailments, but this emotional thing obviously is very difficult to prove. And, you know, everybody seems to have some emotional issues, and it's probably true, but it doesn't mean you could go on the plane with your peacock. So leave the peacock at home.
Do you remember there was a story, it was about a year ago, I think, where a guy knew he was getting fired at his job, and he brought with him an emotional support clown.
Oh, nice.
And the clown mimed crying and did all these amazing things. I love it. They're great stories, but frankly, I don't need that on an airplane.
No.
Keep it to a dog.
Yeah, the clowns scare me, actually.
They scare many, many people.
Yeah, they kind of creep me out. But and last but not least for travel stories, this is one that we've been covering for a long time. American Airlines has started flying Boeing 737 MAXs.
Okay.
So just when you thought it was maybe safe to go on an airplane, you know, the good news is you don't have to worry about the quality of the air. You just want to make sure it stays in the air. So
that's actually made me snort.
I'm sorry about that.
I couldn't get to my mute fast enough.
So it's been 20 months since they've been allowed to fly. They are now allowed. Of course, what they really need to do is to build the consumer confidence. So I think for starters, they're flying with their own employees.
Right.
I think that's a new, instead of layoffs, this is a new way to try.
I guess so.
You start to, maybe your time is up on your job, you know, and they say, hey, how would you like to take the day off and go fly around on this new plane? It's like, I don't know.
Do you have a will?
That's probably a good idea. So all the airlines that are flying it said that they will clearly note on their websites, you know, which flights are the 737 MAX. They also will allow you to change, you know, without any fees. Southwest and United also do have the planes in their fleet. They're not planning until flying them until at least next year. I heard Ryanair, a discount airline in Europe, does not have a great reputation for service, does have a good reputation for being cheap. Okay. They're considering buying a whole bunch of these planes. That's how they could keep their prices so low, because these planes, they're like giving them away at Boeing.
Hey, so it's all a trade-off.
Is, you know, speaking of that, maybe you want to get into the airline business. You might be able to get a really good deal on a 737 MAX.
I should consider a fundraiser.
Yeah, you never know. Yeah, you should go online
How can I make the... Hi, Scott's Cheap Flights. Do you have any Scott's Cheap Planes laying around that I might be able to pick up?
I mean, airplanes are very expensive. If you could get a 30% discount, you're talking about millions of dollars.
That's a massive savings.
It is.
Now is the time.
What can I say? The travel industry and the world is just getting zanier and zanier every day.
It really is.
But it's great for us because we have good material.
Oh, we have good stories to tell, but it's also interesting. But the thing is, it's all reflective of the changes that have been happening in the industry because of COVID-19 and other industry things.
Yes.
So it's really fascinating to watch the progression and the domino effects that we're seeing.
It's just crazy. So anyway, I will report back next week on my trip without an airplane.
Yes.
And we'll see how that goes. Like I say, I'm just putting my toe in the water.
Sure.
And see what happens. But in any event, I've got some great deals for everybody if you want to go a little further away. And many of these deals are for into next year. So it's hopefully going to be a safer time. You're not going to want to miss it. Stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
You better step aside. A lot of men didn't. A lot of men died. I hook to the left. A shank to the right, I'll be looking for my ball until the dark of the night. You play 18 holes.
Do you have a project with an upcoming deadline, but don't have the manpower to finish on time? Or maybe your business just took on a new client and has a sudden demand for qualified professional workers. Whatever your business needs, Labor Finders has got you covered. Gain access to a steady stream of workers who want to work with an agency that always has placements. With over 40 years of experience in the staffing industry, your staffing problem is no problem to our team of experts. Labor Finders covers many services and costs so you can save time and money while getting employees you can count on today. We take pride in setting safety standards. Work with Labor Finders today, the best of staffing winner for 10 consecutive years. From event hosts, chefs, and housekeepers to general laborers, electricians, and landscapers, we have the workers you need. Consult with one of our nearly 200 offices today to see how we can help staff your next big project at laborfinders.com.
And we are back. And the good news is we went through all of our travel news in the last segment, so I could save this segment for a lot of incredible travel deals. I know, Mike, you get a kick out of this.
I love them all. They're amazing.
And there are some great ones here. So we'll get right into it. So the first bunch comes from TravelZoo.com. The first one is if you're like me and you just want to put your toe in the water and perhaps drive to a closer getaway without worrying about the airports and the airlines. Savannah is a wonderful place to go visit. It can be a little bit pricey if you want to stay right in a historic district, but here is a beautiful hotel called, the DeSoto.
Yes.
and pardon me, for as little as $99 a night, Sundays through Thursdays, and $119 on weekends. You can get a beautiful room. You can upgrade to a balcony room for another $10 or $15. That's all that costs. And let's see if there's a deadline on this. There's no deadline on it, but usually these things sell out pretty quick. Oh, here we go. You got to book this by December 16th.
All right.
So you got a little bit of time, but Savannah is a great place to visit and not too far of a drive.
Savannah's fantastic.
It truly is. But if you are a little bit more adventurous, a place that I have visited on several occasions that I love is Costa Rica.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so how about a week in Costa Rica with a rental car? Now, I have to say, the roads and driving there, it's probably less safe than a 737 MAX.
Ooh, well said, Dan.
But many people do have the stomach for it, and you can visit little animals like this.
Oh, there's
like this
a sloth.
Cute little sloth. I've seen the sloths, the monkeys, the toucans. It's a beautiful country. This is for both the Arenal Volcano area, Tamarindo, and San Jose.
Wow.
So three different areas of San Jose, 7 nights of combinations, in decent hotels, and your car, and airfare, daily breakfast in two of your stops, is little as $399 per person. That's a week lodging, breakfast almost every day, a rental car, and airfare. $399 per person.
I had to mute my mic because I really almost
your jaw hit the table here.
An obscenity and surprise there.
And I'm telling you, the volcano area is beautiful. It's active. I've watched it, the lava flowing and the smoke billowing out. There's hot springs in that area that are beautiful as well. Really hot. I mean, crystal clear spring-fed water that's just great to sit in. So, hiking, tubing, and of course, zip lining. They invented the zip line there. Yeah. Everybody's got
I've
it now.
I've always wanted to do that. So
I did it. I am afraid of heights, and I did it. They
Good
forced
for
me
you.
To go. The zip line wasn't bad. It was climbing the rope ladder up to the top of the trees.
Yeah, I thought that would be a challenge.
Yeah, some places they have it where you start at a high
right.
land. And you go down. But this one I had to climb up, and that was freaky. But
I love climbing things, so I'd probably be all about it.
Zip lines. I mean, you're face-to-face with the monkeys and the toucans
awesome.
in their home.
I love
you
it.
Know, it's like, hey.
Nice to see you.
Yeah, just dropping by.
In.
You know?
Happy holidays.
But highly recommend Costa Rica. Another place that I've been to not so long ago that I loved and saw a little bit but would like to see more is Portugal. Here's a package found on Travelzoo by Escapes by Globus. We had them on the show not long ago. Very reputable travel company. A bunch of cities. I can't even pronounce them all. Lisbon, Tomar, Porto, Viseu, and Évora. Okay.
All right.
But
I'll go with that.
This is a guided tour. 8 nights. It includes airfare. You get 5 3-course dinners with wine, private transportation via motor coach, sightseeing that's guided almost every day. All of this for $12.99 per person.
What?
I mean, that's pretty crazy.
$12.99 per person.
Per person. We're talking 8 nights, meals, guided tours, airfare, hotels.
These packages they blow my mind, Dan.
I know. It's almost as cheap as it is to stay home.
It really is.
It doesn't pay to stay home. And, of course, all of these, can be postponed, and you can get a refund if you change your mind. You got to book this one by December 11th, so don't waste
a few days
too much
on
time.
That.
Yep, you got a few. If you want to go even further, how about an African safari?
Yeah.
In South Africa, again, typically outrageously expensive. Very reputable firm, again, Exotica, put this one together.
Okay.
You will go to Johannesburg, Kruger National Park on safari, and Cape Town. So you're seeing a good part of South Africa. How many nights is this? I don't know. It's a whole bunch of nights. You get accommodations, daily breakfast, 3 dinners, 8 nights in well-reviewed accommodations, sightseeing, entrance fees. So it's pretty much the whole kit and caboodle. $16.99 per person.
And that's South Africa.
South Africa, yeah, and that includes your airfare, hotel, food, safaris, everything. It's usually at least $1,000 more than that.
Oh, no question.
At least, per person. So
yeah.
If you're going as a couple, you're going to be saving at
you're
least
$2,000.
Yes, and again, reputable firm. You got to book this by December
10th. Is $2,000 a ton of money?
These are bucket list kinds of things.
But that's crazy. It's literally, that's amazing.
Yeah, according to this, this typically would be about $1,700 more.
Yeah.
And they've got dates through 2022. So you could book it far away and pay it off, you know.
There's literally, I mean, there's nothing to lose on that. It's amazing.
Crazy. Airline deals on Scott's Cheap Flights. I found these. You don't need to go there. Just go to Google Flights. These may or may not be available, but as of today, I checked all of these, and they are all available.
Okay.
Puerto Rico from Miami, $71 round trip nonstop on American Airlines.
Puerto Rico.
St. Croix, which is usually, and actually I checked it and I found some as little as 65. I found them even cheaper on certain days. 65 round trip to Puerto Rico nonstop on American Airlines. St. Croix from Miami, 70 round trip nonstop. That's usually a lot more than San Juan.
Oh, it is.
You know, even though it's nearby, it doesn't have the same volume of traffic, so it usually is a lot more. Same thing, St. Thomas, $75 round trip from Miami. These are short flights.
I'm spending
U.S. You don't need a passport, so you don't have to worry about that.
I'm spending a lot of this show just with my jaw.
I know. I'm sorry about that. If you prefer colder climate and you want to go north, how about Minneapolis from Orlando? $107 round trip nonstop.
Minneapolis
on Delta, and Delta still has the middle seat empty.
Wow, look at that. An extra benefit.
Exactly. So that was pretty good if you want to go to the north. If you want to go further to the north, how about Seattle? This is a little bit more expensive, though. This is $577, so let's not go there. Let's go to Minneapolis. It's much cheaper. Then drive.
I was going to say, go to Minneapolis and drive to Seattle from there, and you're going to...
How about Alaska? Alaska is very far.
Always wanted to check it out.
There's many places in Alaska you could get this deal to. The cheapest is to... Anchorage from Fort Lauderdale, $381.
Well, that is a really good deal to Alaska.
Fairbanks, $393. $391 from Miami. That was from Fort Lauderdale. Juneau, $393. And Ketchikan, $393.
Wow.
So anywhere in Alaska right now is cheap. Japan, $404 from Miami round trip. That's about $1,200 less than usual. Bali is on sale too somewhere, and Tahiti, around $800 or so.
But I mean, compared to what you're normally paying for those things,
it's like
it's a fraction.
Price. Yep. Crazy times we live in.
Benefit from those crazy times.
If you need any help from me, you could always drop me a line. Go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow. Like the page, send me an email, message, and I'll help you out. And tune in again next week, same time, same place, for another episode of The Golf and Travel Show.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show hosted by Dan Shoup. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit 'em straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.